Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of Jermaine Morgan TV. In today's episode, we're going to talk about how to know if you're truly advancing as a bass player. So stay tuned. Before we jump in this lesson, if you like what you've seen so far, do me a huge favor and press that like button, and also go ahead and subscribe and turn on my notifications so you don't miss any video that I put out. Also, you can catch me when I go live, and if you find something helpful on here, be sure to leave a comment and let me know what it was. And as usual, I appreciate you guys for being here. All right, so for some of you guys wondering what I was playing at the beginning, I was just kind of grooving on the old gospel song, Wonderful Is Your Name by Hezekiah Walker. So it's just me having a little fun with the song. Little improvisation, if you will. But jumping right into this, a question I was asked by a student of mine a few weeks ago, it actually made me think, okay, this would be a good idea for a lesson. They asked, how do I know when I'm actually advancing to the next level in my playing? Because oftentimes it's difficult for a beginner to intermediate to really know when that change has happened. And I said, you know what, that's a good thought, because I've never really considered that before, but it's something I want to kind of talk to you and hopefully shine some light on for some of you guys today. So I jotted down a few notes, so you'll see me looking over here to my phone for a few of the notes that I jotted down. So before we get started, this is all my personal opinion based on my own professional experiences. So first off, beginners, recognizing that I am in the beginner stage, that's pretty obvious, right? We're just picking up the bass. The things that I have jotted down here, learning the basic functions of the bass, able to start navigating through bass lines, able to learn one to two songs and play them in about a couple of weeks. That's what I would kind of call a beginner. And of course, the stages of that beginner kind of varies, because you're literally going from scratch, picking up the bass and learning just the basic fundamentals from, you know, the bridge to the tuning pegs, what they do, learning how to tune the strings, where they should be tuned, the nut. And you're learning all the different parts of the bass, the pickups. So you're learning all these different, well, this is some of the stuff you should be learning at the beginner stage. And if some of you guys watching me are not bass players and you're thinking about starting, I do have a beginner course, by the way, on my website, jermainemorgan.net, beginner basics, that shows you all the basic stuff that you should learn getting started, so you can kind of get on the ball with learning this instrument. So you can kind of go back and check that out if you want to do that. But in my opinion, those are some of the things that kind of identify you as a beginner. And when I say learning like one to two songs per week, that's kind of in the latter stage of the beginner, where you're getting to the point where you're actually learning music, you're actually learning material. You are you able to kind of sit down and start picking out certain bass lines and songs. I didn't say it have to be perfect, but you're getting to the point where you're regularly learning music. That's literally at the beginner level. So once you can get to that point, normally I recommend that my students spend at least 10 hours a week practicing. That comes to about 2 hours a day. And that's not a lot when you really think about how much time it takes to really, and I don't like to use the word master, but it is what it is. When you take into consideration how many hours it takes to really know this instrument, that's what you really have to do. You have to put in that at least 10 hours a week. And I say that at the least. If you go over that, that's cool. But actually going over stuff that you're not familiar with and spending time, if you sound great in your practice, you're probably not practicing. I just heard of one of my teachers say that a long time ago. So those are some of the things I think that identify the beginner. Now, moving on to the intermediate stage, your ear has begun to get a lot stronger. Whether you're reading or whether you're playing by ear, you have a fairly solid understanding of this instrument and of just bass lines in general. You're just kind of starting to really, really understand your way around the bass. Not saying that you've mastered it, not saying that you have everything figured out, but you're a little bit more confident as it relates to getting on this instrument, kind of knowing where everything is. You're a little bit more confident when you hear songs. You're able to learn maybe 3 to 4 songs as opposed to learning 1 to 2 songs every couple of weeks. You get to the point where you can probably learn about 3 to 4 songs a week. Now, this is kind of relative to what you do or what environment you're in. And everybody has a different definition of this, but this is just kind of like a general, in my opinion, a general overview of kind of where you are as an intermediate. You kind of know your way around. Now, one thing I want to point out, notice in this thing, I haven't said like, well, you know all your skills, you know all your modes and all that kind of stuff, because at the end of the day, there are a lot of professional players out here who don't know all of that stuff. And they're still professionals, and they still might be considered advanced players. Now, advanced as it relates to knowing all of the theory and all that kind of stuff, they might not be advanced in that regard. But when you hear those records that they played on, it's like, wait a minute, this dude is playing some really cool stuff. So it doesn't always mean you know all of the theory and you know all of the technical aspects of the bass that makes you a beginner, intermediate, or advanced player. All of that stuff, it helps. And it strengthens you as a player to be able to identify that stuff. But in my opinion, it doesn't make or break in determining whether you can actually play this bass or not. Now, last but not least, advanced. What I would consider advanced is details, details, details. And what I mean by that, now, in my opinion, the advanced player has kind of moved beyond just knowing, okay, I'm able to pick out that bass line. All right, I can learn 3 to 4 songs a week or whatever the case may be. But it's like I'm now listening to details. That means if I have to learn a ballad or if I have to learn something that doesn't seem as fun or if I have to learn something that's really repetitive, I'm listening to every single detail in that song to make sure that I'm matching exactly what they are doing. And I'm proficient. Now, let me not leave that point out. Being proficient. As an advanced player, you should be pretty proficient on this instrument. Where I said, you know, as a beginner player, you know, 1 to 2 songs over a couple of weeks, you might be doing okay. And then as, you know, an intermediate player, 3 to 4 songs a week, maybe 5 if you're pushing it, you might be okay. But as an advanced player, the expectations are very high in terms of whatever the amount of songs they throw out to you in a week, you have to be able to do it. You have to be able to learn those songs, execute them, be able to proficiently play this instrument with detail, knowing exactly what it is you're doing. Now, that doesn't mean you have to be able to theoretically name off every single thing that you play, but you should have a knowledge of, okay, I know exactly what it is I'm doing. You should know what you're doing on this instrument and be able to kind of navigate around. I know there was this situation that I had to play this gig with a guy. And most musicians down here in Atlanta have similar stories. Or if you're in any musical city where you may have to get called in to fill in last minute for a gig, there's been gigs that I literally got called for, and I got called 2 days before the gig, and it was like 30 songs, and I had to learn all those songs, not 2 days later, but the rehearsal was the next day, so that means I had to go through and learn all of those songs and be ready for that rehearsal the next day. So to me, an advanced player is knowing your craft, well enough to be able to execute and be called on at any moment and be ready to execute in that moment. Now, you will need to practice. You will still need to practice. You will still need to put the time, still need to put the effort in order to be able to execute what it is you're doing. But until you get to the point where you really know this instrument, where you can literally almost play it with your eyes closed. Now, I will say this. This is my disclaimer. Y'all know I always got to have a disclaimer. And most professionals will tell you this. The more you learn on this instrument, the more you figure out, man, I got a long way to go. And you start to know that this is a never-ending journey. So even as an advanced player, you still know, man, there's so much more to learn. So there is no room for arrogance on any level that you're on. Whether you're intermediate, whether you're beginner, or whether you're advanced, it doesn't matter. You have no room for any arrogance, because at every level, we're all discovering something new. We're all on this journey trying to figure it out, trying to figure out, okay, I can clean this up. And remember when I said about the advanced player, it's all about details, 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 because you start, the more, I don't want to say this, at every level of playing that you find yourself at, your ears will continue to grow. If you allow yourself, your ears will continue to grow. And I would say this to you, get out of your own way. Don't be so mechanical to everything is just, you know, robotic. No, allow yourself to hear. Allow yourself to feel what the music is doing. Allow yourself to feel what's coming through this instrument. Because once you can do that, you can start to connect with this instrument. And it's not so much about mastery as it is having a connection. At least it is for me. It's more so about being able to express what I feel through this instrument, not necessarily just doing a gig so I can get paid. Now, if that's your MO, more power to you. But for me, I think it's more so about a connection with what it is I'm doing, because when I picked up this instrument, I was inspired by something. I gave a scenario to one of my students the other day. I said, I think the problem with most beginners is that it's kind of like that kid at the bike park syndrome. When you are a young kid and you go to your parents take you to the skate park, a bike park or something like that, and you see all of these kids doing these cool tricks and all these things on the bike, you're inspired, not by grandma and grandpa that's riding the bike, you're inspired by the kid that's doing all these flips and all these twirls and all these turns. You're inspired to do that, and that's the thing that gives you the hunger to want to learn how to ride a bike. But when you get your first bike and you start to ride, you figure out, oh man, I gotta figure out how to ride with these training wheels. And then when they take the training wheels off, oh man, I gotta figure out how to stay balanced on this thing. Some of y'all old school, you didn't learn with any training wheels. Even in that, you have to figure out how to gain your balance before you could do anything, before you could go into any of the tricks and know all the things. You have to get the foundation down first. First things first, I gotta figure out how to balance and not fall and scrape up my arm and my knees. That's the first thing first. Foundation has to always be first. Now, the tricks will come along the way, but I think the problem as beginners is we try to get to the tricks too fast, and we often miss the foundation of what needs to be there first. But if you've established that solid foundation, you can do whatever you want to do, because you know that foundation is always there. That foundation is always where you're going to come back to. But even when learning songs, being an advanced player, learning details, you realize that, man, this is important. That's important. All these things in the song are important for me to really, really be the bass player that I need to be. So anyway, not to go on and on with this, I wanted to answer this question for my students that wanted to know, and even for you guys who kind of been struggling with this idea of where really am I as a player? Because I know so many times I ask players, so where would you consider yourself? Would you consider yourself beginner, intermediate, or advanced? And they're like, well, I think I'm intermediate, but you know, when you compare yourself to somebody else, you kind of revert back and say, nah, I think I'm a beginner. So I want to get you to stop doing it and kind of be able to honestly evaluate where you are and see what you need to do to push yourself to that next level. So this has been Jermaine Morgan. I hope you really enjoyed this lesson. Oh, and before I forget, I wanted to let you guys know I'm super excited. I just released my first book that you can actually pick up on Amazon right now, called 10 Ways to Success, The Working Musician. So it's available on Kindle, and it's available as a paperback as well. Now, I will be getting a few copies in as well. I had a few people tell me they want some signed copies. So if you're interested in that, what I would encourage you to do, and you'll get the updates to know when I'm getting these books in and to know how many that I have, because I ordered a very limited run. I didn't order a lot right out of the gate. So if you want to be one of the first ones to get a signed copy of my first book, I'd be happy, more than happy, to get that over to you. So I encourage you to become a member of the monthly membership lessons if you haven't done that already. And also check out some of my courses. I have some really, really cool courses that I think that'll be very helpful for you if you are a bass player that's trying to grow. Even if you're trying to grow in entrepreneurship, one of the things in this book that I talk about is being resourceful. I also have a course called Be Productive and Multiply, where I kind of go through some of those steps of some of the things that I learned to help you be more resourceful so you can start to grow, not only as a bass player, but as an overall entrepreneur, musician. So you're not just always waiting on the next gig, because given our current climate, you know, the gigs are kind of iffy right now. So I want to give you a way to kind of take your career into your own hands so you can start creating some resources for yourself on your own. So be sure to grab a copy of that book, and also be sure to go ahead and start that course as well. Be Productive and Multiply. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for hanging with me today. I will see you guys on next week. I'm out. Peace.